Are you ready?
Cut that garbage off. That's right. I got something to say. You know, last time was kind of fun in the way of I got to see a lot of people's true colors, man. I talked to the snake before I went and had my match. I was excited. You know, he's recovering. He's doing his thing. And I said to him, you know, got a world champion shot. And he said, Jack, glad to see it. You know, glad to see that you're out there. You're getting your shot. The Hunt, McSands, they realize your value, but you never know when it comes to that chat. It can be a little tricky. And I said, you know what, Snake, you keep resting up. You do your thing. I'm out here to go ahead and entertain the people. And I got what they want to see, so let's see what goes on. Match goes down, and we all saw what happened. I ended up losing to some random dollar bin junk. And I had to take it. Okay, that's fine. So then I get the next time to see the next match. I'm doing comedy. I have a front row seat to watch one of the biggest injustices I've ever seen happen on this show ever. And I watched everyone. Not only did you spit in my face as I tried to go ahead and entertain you and show you some great books, you pissed on Stan Lee's grave in that chat. You pissed right in his face. A Stan Lee signature uses some dollar bin garbage, some trash. So I made a decision. Because how everybody likes to go ahead and just now vote for whatever random thing that you like, you don't get the privilege to see my books. You know, a lot of people told me, oh, you haven't earned it yet. Well, you know what? You lost your privilege. You haven't earned seeing the best cut from my collection. You'll never see it again. You like dollar bin books? Guess what you're going to get? All dollar bin. And you know why? Because you haven't actually gone ahead and got the privilege. I will not be wasting my best books on you who don't deserve it.
You know, Jack, I hate to interrupt you, but I have to say, I'm kind of sitting along the same lines as you right now, because for the last 2 years, I've showed up on this show every single time, and I put on these gimmicks, put on this stupid wig. Put on this stupid ass mask to entertain you people and bust my ass on here to think of the best ways I can entertain you, spending money on big ass books So you get to see them because I know you can't afford them. Why? Why? So some random ass dude can come on here and you guys will vote for him. Why? Because he's my friend. He comes on my channel. He's a part of the same army that I am that's ran by some guy that lives in his mom's basement and can't get out of 1990 fucking two. That's why you vote for these people. Oh, I'm going to vote for her because she's pretty. And maybe if I vote for her, she'll say my name on camera. And I can feel better about myself. Damn the books, right? We're just going to shit on the books, disrespect the history behind these books, what these books mean, what this community is supposed to be about. Damn the books, right? And not only that, not only do I have to take the shit from the chat, but then I got to take the shit from the guy who's running the damn show, who uses me for a year solid, uses me to put his own self over, to keep a belt on him. He couldn't get the tag team titles. So let's get the tone and Unkind back together. And we win the titles. And then what does he do? Oh, we're going to go a different direction. Okay, sorry, man. We're going to go a different direction. My ass. I bust my ass just as hard, if not harder, than anyone on here. All right? I go full out with every gimmick that I put out on this show. And I do it better than everybody else on here. And you're going to vote for some guy who can't, and some girl, whoever it is, it doesn't matter, who can't even do the common courtesy of at least coming up with a stupid-ass voice to try to make themselves sound some kind of entertaining. They don't have an entertaining bone in their body. But you're going to give them your vote? That shit stops now. And me and this guy, we're here to make sure that this shit stops now.
Bang, bang.
You smell what the Rock is cooking?
And it's time for a change!
Finally, the world champion's in the building, and I guess I've got to some people's feelings. But in this comic book dealing that we're dealing with, this business here, there's no friends. It's all business. And the tone's what's best for business. I'm sorry to say, the comments made earlier do not reflect the tone, but there are some grievances felt upon in the locker room, so I assume. But the Tone's here to have some fun, so let's get that done. So, man, hey. First off, Spike, good to see you here tonight, man. Hey, I'm going to say this. Whodat's not here tonight. He's feeling a little bit down. You know, he lost the cover championship, you know. But that's all in the past. He's going to move forward. Don't worry about it. But like I said, the nation is still here. And there's never a need to fear, especially for some jabronis running around complaining. The Tone's still maintaining.
Sounds to me like he needs to take his lithium, get back on even kilt, dog, and hey, shut his jabroni mouth, Tone.
Hey, Spike, all I know is tonight, it's you in a grudge match with the Ancient One. And I noticed around lately that I've been holding up my end of the deal. Lady Fantastic's been holding up her end of the deal. And, yeah, I mean, Whodat slipped up a little bit. I mean, he's not as good as the Tone, but who is? So all I'm going to say is this. Don't mess up tonight. It's a grudge match. Make it happen.
I'm a 16-time tag champion, Tone. How can I mess things up?
Well, speaking of match, hey, we got a match tonight with TV Championship. It's going to be on the line. Lady Fantastic's in the back getting ready. So, I do believe that the opponent is none other than the Bleecker Street Barber.
It's good to be here, my man.
Hey, man. Good to see you. Good to see you. See you back on the hunt for some more gold, I see.
Yes, sir. We're here looking for gold. I noticed that Tylox the mustache is not in the building. Running scared after that travesty that happened last show.
Hey. All I know is you guys are entitled to a rematch. That's what McSans told me. So more than likely, you will get a shot again. It is in the works. But for right now, you got a shot at the coveted TV championship over here. So let's get one of the best in the business out here, Lady Fantastic. Hit our music.
You smell what the Rock is cooking?
And it's time for a change.
Second, wait, what's going on? Hold on a second.
Is the whole nation running scared for me?
Hey, hold on a second. Something's not right here. I said, like, oh, wait a minute. Hold
on. Come on out here, Lady Fantastic.
Hold on a second. Something's going on in the back. Hold on a second. We got cameras in the back. Hold on. Second, hold on. Spike, get back there real quick. Go back there and check on her.
What just happened?
So,
hey, I don't like to win any matches like that. I do not want to win any matches like that.
Hey, all I can say is she's not going to be able to compete tonight. You can see right there, she was attacked in the back by somebody from Slab Down. I don't know what those jabronis are doing around over here, but we haven't seen them in a long time. But Slab Down was in our locker room area. We got Spike in the back checking it out. So, unfortunately, Bleecker, I'm going to have to call it for you, man. You're going to have to win this by forfeit. No title change here, but you are winning this match by forfeiture.
Well, you know, Tone, I'll get that title back. Still got mine right here. I know we're waiting to win it back. We're waiting to win those tag team champions back. Come on, Tylox, get your ass out here.
So... hey, I need you to hang out with me real quick because right now we're going to have to do this grudge match. And the guy in the back is known for doing pulling a lot of tricks, man. Really tricky guy back there.
Oh, so, he's slippery, all right. He's slippery.
So you got to watch him, man. He's known to pull some fast ones.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I will take care of it. I just got here. I'll take care of the match. I understand. I'm really busy, but I will do it. I understand. Okay, I'll let you know how it goes on Monday. All right, thank you, sir. Sorry, Tone. I just got off the phone. Uh-oh, can you guys hear me all right?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Oh, good. All right, good. Everything's going wrong. I didn't know if my audio went out. The Teng Shun just gave me a call saying he can't make it tonight, so he said, can you take care of this situation? I don't know what's going on with Chris, with the Spike and himself. Apparently, they're ticked off at each other, so I'm here to fill in for him. Where is he, by the way? Is he he's run away?
No, he's in the back checking on Lady right. Fantastic. She was attacked, but he will be up front here in a second. He is, but he was expecting the Ancient One. He didn't expect for the Attorney at Law, for IRS Attorney at Law. Dan, what are you doing here? So
do they need a lawyer, by the way? They can give me a call if there's a fight backstage.
hey, talk with Lady Fantastic later here in a minute. But for right now, you need to focus on this matchup at hand because Spike is coming back up front. So let me get him out here real quick. I would hit his music, but the Tone doesn't really need to hit the music that many times. Spike, how's everything back there, man? How's everything going on back there?
They fucking ran Tone. They saw me come in. They booked it. They booked it like those 16-year-old hooligans who stole the radio out of your car at 2 o'clock in the afternoon when you were taking a nap.
Hey, all I got to say is slap down, you've been put on notice. So, let's get this match underway. Spike, as you can see, the Attorney at Law's here, and for some reason, I guess the Ancient One's ducking you, man.
No, actually, that's not true, Tone. The Ancient One has something in mind. He told me I have to be here. He's going to observe from afar. He's in another dimension right now. But right now, I'm it. So, Spike, you have to go against me, and you'll be dealing with the Ancient One soon enough.
Bona pissed me off.
That's up to him. I get paid if I win or lose. It doesn't matter to me.
All right. Well, let's get this on and cracking. So.
All right. I'll go first if you want. So. Here's a good one, by the way. Always love this cover. Thing versus Ghost Rider. Marvel 2-in-1 number 80. Look at that Ghost Rider. That's very Ploog-like. Love the art on this.
Very cool Ghost Rider.
Yeah. These are underrated series, by the way, the Marvel 2-in-1s.
Right. I thought since this is my first actual match in, I don't know, 4 months, I'd be somewhat topical. Some Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Oh, he come out swinging. Check him out.
Episode 1, Obi-Wan. Here we go, eh?
I can see he's got the look of determination tonight.
Oh, yeah. Force is strong in that one. Let's get the votes in, people.
But everybody loves Ghost Rider, though. I love Ghost Rider.
And hang around after this. After this match right here, we're going to do a giveaway. Let's get those votes in. We got Obi-Wan. We got the Ghost Rider racing the thing, doing his thing.
Come on, people. Which one of these amazing comics is going to win this battle?
So far, it's tied up. Let's get those votes in.
Got to vote for Bleaker in there.
I see that.
They love you, Bleaker.
They also love Jeffrey.
Got to give that one to my partner there.
All right, I'm about to call this one for Dan the Man on this one.
Right. Well, it's working good on this one. All right. Remember, the Ancient One is observing this match. He's texting me as we speak. So, anyway, this is a hot book, by the way. And this is... Well, it speaks for itself. first appearance of Franklin Storm as an adult. Fantastic Four, snap. Number 245.
Pulling it out.
Yeah, there it is. Good cover. Great cover, actually.
John Byrne, yeah, that great run that he had.
Yeah, it's a really nice cover.
I would right. fill this one in the bag, but... Plus 705, the variant uh-oh. Edition.
Art germ for the perm.
With Jane on the cover.
Look at him. You see why he's a former world champion?
Throwing up some heat there tonight, Spike. Throwing up some heat, buddy.
Let's get those votes in. He's going lady for lady this round.
We know this is coming. This is guaranteed.
Yeah, she would be if I was there.
She's on a list of many.
Let's get those votes in, people.
You know, the only thing that would make this cover better is if we had Art Germ somewhere sign on this cover.
We got Spike in the lead here, people.
Mm-hmm. Spike's in the lead.
Been a while since I thought of that.
It's a good battle, this one. Great covers. Both really nice covers.
Support from the boss.
I think that's the first time that I've ever gotten support from the boss.
I can't complain. He's one of my best customers. So if he votes for Spike, it is what it is.
I'm not sure. There's some legalities happening here.
not when I cash a check at the bank. I'm not caring about that.
Let's get the votes in, people.
Of course, it's legal. He signs all of our paychecks.
Well, McSans and I don't always see eye to eye, but he's got a great organization. I'll give him that.
He's got a great attorney. Just throwing that out.
No.
I have to give it to Spike on this one.
Killing it with that. Yeah, there we go.
First time I've won around since that tag match I had against Unkind.
Going back to Dan the Man.
Right. This has been hot for the longest time. I believe this is Cop Rage. And it's good 90s foil copy, Amazing Spider-Man 375. Good old Venom cover.
Yeah, that gold 90s foil, baby.
Yeah, that was popular.
Nice.
This one's still holding up pretty good. It's not chipping or anything.
What's that in the top corner, though? that looks like chipping. So I'm going to show this...
Wait, you can see that with those smudge glasses? You got to be kidding me.
I have 20/10 eyesight.
Sure.
Batman 1, the Hastings variant by Tyler Cookham.
Uh-oh. He's pulling it out.
Tyler, yeah, fuck, pulling it out on live TV here, Spike.
Uh-oh, he said he don't need the...
It won't be the last time.
Oh, Hastings! They ain't even around.
This is very indicative of when I was world champion.
Get those votes in on this one.
With the stick.
Let's get the votes in.
Gold foil.
Not gonna lie, I still dig the foil covers, man. That's my era.
I didn't like them at first, but they've grown on me.
Yeah, even now when they make a foil cover, that foil cover of the what is it? Something's Killing the Children, number one.
Like, yes.
I'll take that. Thank you.
I've not seen that in person.
What 2010 Vision needs, Blue Hellion, is what the average jabroni can see from 10 feet away, I can see from 20 feet away.
Spike, how many fingers am I holding up?
Look like I'm about to call this one for Dan the man on this one.
Right.
So it's 2-1, 2-1.
Mm. Now, Spike, I know you like horror comics because you've shown them before, and I got one here that I think you and the chat would really appreciate if I could take this out carefully.
Horror comics or horror comics?
Horror comics.
I gotta ask. I have a friend who, when she says horror, it sounds like that other one, and we always have to ask.
All right, this is Haunted Horror number 12, and the reason why I bring that up is this, is because I had this gentleman sign this about 3 years ago, a guy by the name of Jack Katz. He's a horror classic artist from the 50s. He signed it right there. There's his autograph right there. Actually, he signed it twice, there and there. That's the autograph I got from him. But that's 1952 horror. He was the guy who did it. He's still alive, by the way. He's 94 last time I
looked. God bless him.
Yeah, yeah. Interesting fellow. I talked to him at length. Man, interesting time in the 50s when he put this together. All pre-cold horror.
Is that a book straight from the 50s, Dan?
No, it's just a reprint. Yeah.
Riff's totally distracted on this. I can't believe this.
So they want gimmicks, I can see. So I had to break this out. It's a complete set of 1992 Fleer basketball cards.
Oh, he pulled out a foreign object in the match. He pulled it out.
Complete set.
Oh.
What? I'll skip to what everybody wants to see. Everybody wants to see that Michael Jordan card.
There it is.
Are we on Spine Ticks now? Did we change shows?
Damn. Let's get those votes in. We're going to allow this.
unprecedented
move here.
It's just legal and dubious, but I guess I'll keep quiet about it. That's fine.
And against the lawyer.
Yeah.
It's big cojones on you there, Spike. Big cojones.
Yeah.
Let's see this one go down here.
I put you like this. Ooh. I bought the whole booster box on eBay for $25. Got the complete set. This bind all, $1,700 if I was to sell it. That's a very large percent of what you might call markup and profit.
You don't gotta sell me, Spike. You gotta sell that crowd down there.
Yeah.
Where's that?
Oh, here we go. Here's my pick for this year's finals, by the way. The Celtics.
Celtics. You and the Snake both, eh? You and the Snake both. You know, I think Spike won with a fake horror book once.
No, this one's going to Dan because Dan got this one.
I want a recount.
All right. Where are we at, Tony? Is that over? We got more to go.
It's 3-1. You pulled it off. But if you want to go, if you're a gambling man and bet everything all at the last round, if you want to go for one for everything.
Last round. We got a
I don't care. Like I said, I get paid if I win or lose. It doesn't matter to me. So.
Oh, man, we're going to all the marbles, people. All the marbles.
Is. One all book right. is it. Pick your all best right. ones.
Okay, here we go. You ready, Spike? Here we go. How about some Doctor Strange number one?
Oh, he came in with the kill at the end. Look at
saving it.
Hit the finishing move. Can Spike kick out and save his reputation in the nation? Oh, I think he did. I think he did. It's hot. I see the flames. I see the flames off of it. That is a hot book.
For sure, I got
book.
One of those hanging in my shop right now. That's a hot, hot, hot book.
We got two good ones here, people. Can't complain on either side.
Still the number one movie in the country, as I understand it.
Every movie is the number one movie in the country.
Yeah, but not the Ghost Rider movie, the Doctor Strange movie.
Yeah, but we all know that Doctor Strange came and he was a letdown. Ghost Rider, he's yet to come, and he's going to blow up like some might say pyro, some might say nitro.
Do you remember the Nicolas Cage movie?
The first one or the second one?
The second one is really awful. God, it was awful.
I'll give you the second one was awful.
Who were they looking at for him? I think they're looking at John Wick for.
I think so. Rider, I think so. Right?
Yeah.
I would stick with Matthew McConaughey because he's kind of creepy and goofy anyway. He's dark anyway. If you saw him in, True Detective.
Yeah, as long as he doesn't do that Southern drawl, we'll be all right.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Let's get the votes in.
Doctor Strange won. Two
beautiful books, actually. Gorgeous books. That 25-cent Doctor Strange and that gorgeous Ghost Rider. Perfect. Looks like a 9.8 to me from here.
Yeah, this is really high grade, by the way. Got to be very careful with it.
So far, Dan's up. Let's get some more votes in. Let's see how it's going to go. Don't forget, we got this giveaway coming up here in a minute.
Spike, you're giving it your all. Played some hot books tonight, my man.
I just pulled things out at random.
And we're going to give this.
I do what Spike does. I just show up.
And with lethal authority, Dan, the attorney, comes through for his client.
Well, I just got a text from the Ancient One, Spike, and he said he is very, very impressed with you. He would like to face you in person at the next match. What say you, sir?
I'll take it, but you never. But for all I know, by then I could fall from the ceiling.
All right, it's on. Celebratory drink of Cabernet. To you, Spike.
Congratulations. Spike.
You pulled it out so fast, and you say I'm the one with the drinking problem.
I didn't say that.
You have said that.
You were ticked off at Ancient One. So look, he's going to be here in 2 weeks. You take it up with him. I'm just his attorney.
Hey. All I got to say is, Spike, I'm highly disappointed in you, but you're lucky it wasn't the Ancient One. So... You got another shot, son. The tone has got his eye on you.
So next week I have to go up to the catwalks?
Hey. Yeah. Trust me, the Ancient One's got some up his sleeve, so you got to wait for 2 weeks to see what he's planning.
I don't know if I have to go up to the catwalks. I don't know. I have a bad feeling about that.
You talk to Mix Hands about that.
The Ancient One's pretty sneaky. I'd watch yourself.
All right, so chat real I'd quick. I'd watch out, too. We're going to do a giveaway real quick, so we're going to give these two books away to a lucky person. So I got Moon Knight, Black, White, and Blood 1, and Deadpool, Black, White, and Blood 1 as well. Giving these two away.
Very cool.
I'll put in the private chat. Hold on a second. We're going to do a number because usually I do trivia, but we're going to do that for later on for the comic in the bank. So we'll do a number from 1 to 30. And let me get this. Hold on a second. Let me get the line in real quick. Go ahead and start. Numbers 1 through 30.
Keep going, people. Keep going. Haven't seen it yet.
Southern Comic Geek 69.
16, a great number. Great number. A little higher. Southern Comic Geek.
Southern Comic Geek wins.
There it is. Christina Wagner.
Yep.
Yep.
Christina
Wagner.
Killing it with the Jordan, baby.
Well, I got the inspiration from Spike real quick.
I think Tone was subliminally, used by Spike.
I got some tricks up my sleeve.
You're going to need them for the anxious 1 or 2 weeks.
I'm going to need more than some tricks up my sleeve. I might need a parachute.
All right. So, let's get it on, people. We got to get on to the comic in the bank. And if you're not familiar with this, this is how it's going to go down. We're going to have four contestants. They're going to come in. They're going to do rounds just like we are doing right now. You get to vote. If the person wins, they got to go up the rung on the ladder. If they get to the top, they have to retrieve the case and answer a trivia question. Now, there are knockdowns, which each combatant has, where they can knock down the person that is up on the ladder.
How many knockdowns does each combatant get, Tom?
So far, they get one.
Beautiful.
So, we're going to see how this is going to work out. This has never been done before. It's the first time attempt.
First time on the hunt. The first time on the match.
History in the making. You're seeing it for the first time. Go tell your friends. Go share this out. Let everybody know what's going on.
Unbelievable.
Tell your moms, your dads.
Just when you thought the show couldn't get any better. Bam, ladder match, baby.
Tell
ladder
your wives,
match.
Your mistresses, your sons, your daughters, your dogs, your cats, your raccoons. Tell everyone.
So let's get them out here.
Don't tell all your mistresses.
No. Not all of them, but some of them.
Keep a few in the dark. That's just legal advice.
Well, you don't tell the wives about the mistresses.
Attaboy. That's it. Yeah.
I may have been born a Dudley. this Dudley ain't no dummy.
Yeah. Free legal advice on this show.
Oh yeah. So man, we gotta get these people out here because gotta get this match started, man.
Right. Spike, good job, sir. Good job.
Who we got tonight, Tone? Who we got?
Hey, man. Let me let you first know. You can't have a ladder match without the Hall of Famer, one of the best in the business, my best friend, a guy that holds it down, runs around, and you know who I'm talking about. Ladies, hold your hearts because they're about to get broke.
Are you ready? I know I'm sexy. I've got the looks. The drives are going wild. I've got the moves. I really move. I said shit. Up and down that spine. I'm just a sexy boy. I'm not your boy. I'm just a sexy boy.
Holy shit. A heartbreak kid.
What is going on, guys? Let me tell you something, Tone. Is McSans out there? Can he hear me? Because he's got a bunch of little whining bitches in his locker room. Let me tell you. All these guys are complaining because they're having performance issues. Let me tell you. Blaming this on the chat, guys? Come on now. If you had the books to get the job done, you would have.
And this is coming from the man that has won the Hunt World Championship, the title I hold right here in my hand without a book, so he can get the job done, son. So, let's get this on and cracking without any lacking. There's still people in the back. So, one of these guys you might know, he's been on the show before. And, man, all I can say is, I don't know, man. I'm worried about bringing him out here. I'm worried about bringing him out here. Because he's not really stable, you know what I'm saying? He's not really in the right mind.
We'll be right back.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Not only is the Tone gonna put himself in the match, let's bring back the old guy who never shows up, that's gonna take the spot of those of us who have been here week after week busting our asses. Let's give him the spotlight. That makes that's a real Tone.
Because you're all a bunch of losers. I'm the only winner in the locker room.
Jesus Christ, give me a break.
Yeah, the only way that you win is with your blue chew.
Let's get the
one more than you.
Let's get the former world champion out here. This guy's a former world champion, Grand Slam champion, first ever. You already know who it is.
No shows tonight, Tone. A lot of no shows. There
he
is.
Yo,
they better show.
Yo, have no worries, brother. Your fearless leader has returned, dude. And everybody's all hot and bothered. And there's situations to be handled, dude. But I just want to say congratulations to the world champion, Tony Sanders, dude. Yo, you're running a tight ship. This is a great show. And everybody knows these books. It takes a lot of blood, sweat, and tears. So I don't mind when the chat represents for their favorite competitors, man. You guys vote for whoever you want to vote for, dude. But thanks for having me on, Tony.
Oh, man. Thanks for being involved in this match. This is historic. This is going to be the first time ever. A ladder match, man. We ain't never had this before. So there's still one more guy in the back that's
the only other sensible person on this damn show.
Whatever.
Mike?
The main culprit of this whole counterculture thing going on here, the heartbreak kid talking about I won with notebook. That's part of the problem, sir. You're not part of the solution, you're part of the problem.
Thank you. Thank you.
Haters. Gotta hate.
We better start separating these guys before they before they wreck themselves before the match, Tone.
Yeah. I mean,
that makes them more interesting though.
There you go.
There we go.
Hi, chat. How you doing?
Someone took the lithium today.
So, all right, man.
We are lucky, Roscoe, because if you were here, then everybody would just vote for your dollar books instead of real books that I'm going to show off. We are lucky you're not here, Roscoe.
If you start showing those jabroni-ass dollar books, I'm going to jump in that ring, and I'm going to take you down myself unkind.
So we're going to go round for round. And each person that wins a round gets to climb up the ladder. But remember, knockdowns are allowed. So we will go first with Unkind.
Lucky number one, huh? Yeah. It doesn't matter what I like show to start with.
You ain't go pass up on a chance to shit on that.
Here. Let's not vote for some iconic Jack Kirby and Dr. Doom early Fantastic Four books. Let's see what kind of color classics illustrated you guys want to vote for tonight.
Love that comic.
Beautiful.
Yeah, you know what? I don't think these real wrestlers even got books we got.
Yeah.
This is the real comic book wrestling championship, dude. Yeah. I don't even think real wrestlers got books we got, dude. All right. Yo. We got that Blade Wizard in half with the cert, dude. What's up, man?
Oh, snap. Got the foreign object in there. It's loud. It's a loud ladder match. You can pull it off.
Gimmick. Let's show the gimmicks. Ooh.
Says right. The gimmick.
So let's go over to Boston.
Don't worry about me. All right. Well, let's see. What should I go with? Well, let's go with this. This, I mean, got a bunch of, you know, random characters on a cover here, and you know, clearly I'm gonna win this round because it's some dollar bullshit. But it's got a whole bunch of characters that are just on it. And, you know, this is what people value more than Stan Lee's, you know, books that are Silver Age keys. So, shit, I won this already. So, get me up the ladder.
That is the new Defenders, by the way. That is the new Defenders. Don't knock that book, actually. It's actually better than you think.
Come on, Jeffrey. You're
the Hall of Famer.
Ooh.
Oh, he comes out swinging. Oh.
He yanks out his thing.
Fantastic Four. So,
That's how you feel?
That's how you feel, champ. I mean, we're starting off slow, so I thought I'd go with this one.
Oh. He said you got to catch up. Whoa.
Dirty.
Flipping out your thing isn't
slow.
Get
the votes in. Let's get the votes in, people.
Is there a reason to vote? Because this is already over. I mean, let's go to the next round. Discount bin rules. Let's go. I mean, what are we doing? Jefferson. George.
That was close. It was close.
I don't know about that blade, man.
I should have pulled out one of these that had the cover half ripped off instead of a hybrid copy. That probably would have done me a little better.
That's a nice copy, my man. That's a nice copy.
Mine's got the whole cover on it.
You know what would get you the win? Unkind is if your book had no cover at all.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was getting hot. Let's get the votes in, people.
Oh, no love for the Wizard.
It's between the Fantastic Four. It's between Jeffrey and Unkind right now. Let's get the votes in.
I feel y'all.
I mean, it's an affordable book. There's no need to be jealous. You can actually get this one. Isn't that fun?
We got a solid tie.
Last time people didn't like this book, so they couldn't afford.
We need the next vote. Breaks the tie. We need the next vote.
Is the winning vote. Now look at those two beautiful
books.
Who's going to win
the first and fourth round of the ladder match?
My guys, we got 15 people in the chat.
Look at those two beautiful books.
We only got six, seven votes.
Wow.
We're not going to talk about the fact that we're looking at Marvel's number one villain ever, and then a guy made of rocks.
My favorite villain. My favorite villain.
Well, I don't see Mephisto on that cover.
Give me a break, Mephisto.
Come on now.
Let's get the votes in. We got a tie. Need a tiebreaker.
Oh, I'm sorry. You mean Green Goblin.
That book was more artificial than the Tone's hair color.
Hey, this is all natural, son. I'll tell you right now.
No, McStan, on the other hand.
Yeah, so what's that Mephisto spec?
So now the chat's forgotten how to vote. What's going on here?
I think we ran out of people who can actually vote.
I think the chat's pissed off. They're not voting. They're stagnant. We got 16 people in the chat. We got six
Nobody's
votes.
Voting. Come on, get a vote. Where's the votes at, people? We need one more vote.
More people on this panel voting than people in the chat.
I honestly think that everybody who voted is on the panel.
Come on. Somebody can vote.
Oh, yeah.
Shit, you know what?
Break this tie, people. Break this tie.
Nope.
Come on.
If you're the most beautiful Fantastic Four books I've ever seen.
Did you guys not follow your followers on Instagram and other social media to get your votes? I don't understand.
I'd love to own either one of those bad boys. I forgot to tell all my friends.
We're trying to get the ladder match. Come on, people. One vote. We get the first step up.
We now have 18 people in the chat and still six votes.
Yeah, hold on. Let me go join the PCP army. Maybe I'll get some
breaks
votes.
The tie.
Give me a break.
Unkind with that round.
Right. So we'll go up one rung for Unkind. Finally.
I could go first this time. We don't have to hammer Unkind the whole match. Yeah.
Biggie, so, gentlemen, as always.
Which is weird.
I think he's somewhere adorable.
All right, so we got one rung. We got one lighter rung, people. Let's get the votes in on this next one. So we're going to Biggie on the first one.
All right, man. I'm going to go with that first. Oh. Zeus, baby.
Ooh. First Hercules.
Yes.
Nice.
A hot book. Hot book.
Hercules is great.
This is what you want, boys. It's the one.
I don't see any fire on it. Can't be that hot.
All right. We're going to go to Boston Jack.
All right. Who likes shiny covers? Everyone likes shiny covers, apparently. Or maybe they don't. I don't know. But, yeah, we're going to go at Night Thrasher 1. Because you guys can get this anywhere, right? People love shit like this. So come and get it. Look, Night Thrasher 1. He's angry. Look how mad he is.
That's what they love. Is that a valuable direct edition?
No, you can't get it everywhere. I've looked.
Oh, you can get it everywhere. All right. It's everywhere.
You can get it almost everywhere. All
right. Going to Unkind.
Yeah, we can talk about the hot books now. Something that's gonna die out in 6 months. And even though you people don't even deserve to see this book, I've purposely not shown it to you because you don't deserve to see it here. I'm gonna show it tonight anyway.
Neil Adams goodness.
Nice.
Probably one of the most iconic, if not the most iconic. Which was homaged by the most iconic Batman cover. We don't like to vote for stuff like this, though. That's not what we're about here on the hunting.
Name the original. Name the original.
Uncon, who signed that? That's a signed copy. Who is that?
Neil Adams.
You know what I'm saying? He did sign it. Okay.
Yep.
All right. Jeffrey.
First Ooh. Full appearance of the leader.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Look at Jeffrey, you coming out hard.
And an underrated going book.
Going to his wheelhouse.
Look at him. He's getting old. Let's get the votes in.
You only collect Hulk.
Well, that's not only. Just
color when you move it.
Let's get the votes in. Let's see who's going to move up the ladder. Let's see who's moving up the ladder. We got a Neil Adams signed Batman 7.0.
Tech 31 homage.
We got the first appearance of Hercules and Zeus.
Damn.
We got Shiny
Hercules,
Night Thrasher.
Hercules, baby.
Damn.
Shiny Night Thrasher.
The ancient one should have been in this match, damn it.
Nah, you don't have dollar bin books, bro.
I do.
You don't have any trash.
Let's get
trash
the votes
books.
In. What's Let's up? Get the votes in.
What's up, dude? I take Look my book
Look
every
at that
day.
Thrasher. Week. Look at that Thrasher. Fucking gorgeous.
You know what?
Bleaker, I love you, man.
You laugh, but a book about the same quality of this beat a Hulk one in like a week or a month ago.
I
got
a
vote. Why not? Why not?
It got a vote. In the Twitch chat.
So it's looking like Unkind won this round.
Running away with it. Running away with it.
So now they're afraid of Unkind.
He done moved up the rung of the ladder. He's almost to the top of the ladder, people. He's almost to the top. But don't forget, there are knockdowns. And they are saving them, I see. They are saving them.
Is this like if somebody wins this next round, can they win it? No? Not yet, right?
Oh, he can. When he gets to the next one, it's gonna be the third, and then he can do the trivia question. But y'all have knockdowns.
Yeah, so. No, that's why I won't wait until the fool gets knock his ass.
Some strategy.
Somebody's got to. See. I ain't trying to lose.
So, all right.
You don't win a title; you win the chance for one.
That's what I'm saying.
We're gonna go back. We're gonna go to Boston, Chris. This time, Boston Jack.
All right. I'm excited. I don't even know. You know what? let me throw something with a little movie clout behind it. So yeah, man, this is something that you guys, I don't know, maybe you have it, maybe you don't, maybe you overpaid for it if you do have it, which is sad, but that's all right. That's all right, because this actually was in the movie, and so it does have a little movie clout. And what it is that it was in Far From Home. See, there was a license plate that had the name of the book, MTU 139. That was Aunt May's car. Isn't that cool? Don't you guys want to buy this book? Shit. What an amazing book. Harry in a movie.
That Aunt May in that movie, she was pretty hot.
Going to the Hall of Famer, Jeffrey.
Oh! I showed two of those last time, so you may not get both on that, my friend. I don't know what to tell you.
Quit living in the past, bro.
He said he's got this. He said, hold up. Oh.
Wait, Hulk isn't in that book.
Going to Biggie because Unkind rolled out of the ring. Going to Biggie.
Oh,
Golden Age.
That's unfair. That's totally unfair.
I can't even hate on that.
Nobody can. That's a gorgeous book.
Barrett, challenge accepted. Hate on that book.
It's
maybe.
And we're going to Unkind.
I've seen it before. I like the one before it.
Now, while I would like to think that you imbeciles in the chat would have the capacity to understand that Golden Age Captain America is the best book that'll be shown this round, my faith is lacking. And we're not going to talk about that raw copy of this book, because that doesn't stand a chance. We're going to talk about the fact that I did something none of you have the balls to do. I took Hulk 181 and I cracked it out of the slab. And cleaned and pressed it. And I'm going to resubmit it. I took the chance because I have the balls to do that. So that's what I'm going to show this round. I'm going to show something that none of you will ever show. And that is a little bit of guts.
Damn, it looks nice, damn. Dude. He took it from a 2.0 to probably like a 4 or 5. That's amazing. Yeah.
Last time I showed guts, I had a hernia. It wasn't pretty.
I don't know that this is the best book now. That 181 is probably worth twice this. I got notes on it, though. It's volume 1, number 68, 1948, worn top, creased, and marked. But listen. Complete.
Ooh.
That's pretty good.
Is that a Schomburg?
You challenged me to shit on that, Iveson. Boston?
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's too late for Schomburg.
Yeah,
Boston, you challenged me to shit on that, and Biggie.
I love Iverson's work. He is amazing.
And no offense to you, Biggie, but that ain't
anybody
who
worked on the
Timely
and Atlas. All those guys were great.
Let's
get those votes in.
How you gonna vote against?
Although the
MCU
people in the chat probably have no idea what we're talking about.
A lot of the time, they don't really even know who did the cover. It could have been Iverson. It could have been Schomburg. Who knows?
One of the most affordable MCU books, MCU-linked books. And no votes.
It does look like Iverson, though. So I'm just
you want an affordable MCU book?
Yes.
You got the first appearance of Maria Hill.
It's tied up.
That's like a $5 book.
No, I got to give Boston Jackson credit. He is doing a great job selling those dollar bin books.
I mean,
he's no Ross.
These are the books that feed $400 and $500 books. It's not even $1,000 books.
Next vote.
Damn, Trevor, no love. Why you like Hulk 181? I ain't gonna hate on you.
Where's the love?
I think Ultimate just won the whole fucking ladder match, y'all.
You want to know how Roscoe's able to beat the $4,000 or $5,000, $10,000
sweet, unkind
book.
Domination.
He's got charisma.
Oh no, it's still tied up on this last one.
You can't help but dance when you hear Roscoe's music.
Tied up.
Come on, guys. 16 people still in this chat. We only got 6 votes.
Goodness versus that 181 that everybody wants.
So once the ladder's set up, all right, once the ladder's set up, we need one more vote.
I think I got 182 kicking around here.
Frogger on the back. Atari. What?
Oh, hold up, Laker. You'll probably win the whole
way.
Thing.
Biggie won. Biggie won the round.
Impossible.
Ricky Tech.
So, let's see.
Biggie,
so
nice job, man.
Yeah, here we go.
That was close.
That's a beauty book.
I'm surprised Boston didn't win.
Wow. You got a vote.
And there's an uncon vote later on.
You got to join the army, Chris. You got to join the army, Jack. That's how you win with those books, bro.
All right. Wow. So now the ladder's complete, people. So this is what's going to happen. Whoever wins, like if you win a round, you have the option to go for the trivia question. But remember, knockdown.
Yeah, knock a fucking down. Bam.
Crouch
him. So knockdown's only if you miss the trivia.
No, I get a knockdown, so he don't get to the next round.
Yeah,
like, back down to the bottom.
I got a round, so should I use it against Dustin?
Somebody needs to whoever's at the top, somebody, I'll knock him down. It doesn't matter, but somebody needs
Dustin's to at the top. Down. I need to use my knockdown.
Yeah, Dustin's at the top, yeah.
I gotta use my knockdown. You gotta come down.
We all get one.
How did Dustin get to the top if Biggie just won that round?
I don't know.
Oh no, he's at the second part. I'm at the first part. That's right.
He should be at the second.
Yeah. That's right. Okay, we can keep going. You're right. I'm sorry.
I'm just saying
the ladder's complete. That's all I'm saying is because you won a round, the ladder's complete. So it's complete. So all you gotta do is like. You can lock him.
Whoever wins this round is at the top.
Yeah.
He would be tied.
This round right here, anybody, whoever wins this round is at the top and can go for the question.
Oh, we can
That's what we're saying. Once the ladder is complete.
Yeah, me and Biggie built the ladder, but anybody can grab the bat.
Oh, really?
Anybody can grab it now. That's what we're saying. Yeah.
Oh, baby, let's go.
Oh, no shit. Okay.
All right, so we're gonna go to Jeffrey because everybody went first, but Jeffrey. So Jeffrey's going first this round.
Yeah, we better get him in here. It's probably close to bedtime.
Whatever.
Ooh.
Oh,
oh no.
Damn. Ooh. Got the whole couch. Ooh.
Damn, that's gorgeous.
Might not be gorgeous.
Man, oh, we know what it is.
I don't care if it's a 1-8. It's still gorgeous. That's a whole 3.
Yeah, we see you, Jeff.
All right. We're just going to go down to Boston.
I'm not afraid of that at all. You know why? Because this book that I have here.
Ravage 2099.
Double-sized, double-team excitement. Sounds dirty, doesn't it?
Barely.
And, you know, we got ourselves... Avengers 250. Now, see, we get them fighting a big hand. Don't know why, but they're fighting some big-ass hand. And you know what? There's a guy on this cover, right? Right there, who beat a $500 book last week. So,
oh, look at there. Look at that. Shut it down and ask this man the question.
Hey, I'm sorry if the world champion is just...
Guy giving the books away. He's sorry if he's the one getting the votes.
We're going over to Biggie.
I would do HBK dirty and show my hog too, but I'm not going to do that. I'm gonna do this instead. I'm gonna use that Swampy baby.
Ooh, damn.
A book that started the number one contender cream.
That's a sweet book.
Yeah, this is the first appearance. That's why I picked this.
The first appearance of Weezy too.
Louis
Simonson on the cover.
Okay. All right. If we're gonna show monsters, let's show some monsters. I'm gonna show a book that the last time I showed it when it was raw, people in the chat, they were too ignorant to understand the significance of it, even though it's not the first print. The fact that it is from 1966, still just 4 years after the first print, and it still hit an 8.0. Yeah. But no one in the chat last time understood the significance of something like this.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it's a facsimile. No, it's from 1966, fool. So it still hit an 8.0. Show me your book from the 60s. It's an 8.0.
Jesus Christ, you got
it. Oh, man. Let's get the votes in. Whoever wins this round right here.
Beating up that pinky finger. He says, $500 books don't mean shit. Look at me.
There you go. Talk your shit.
That, you know what? You know whose hand that is? You remember when Mae Young
don't
gave
sleep
Brooks
on that
the
whole
hand?
Three, man. Jeffrey's probably got like a 4.0 or some shit up there. What is that, 1.8? Goddamn.
Yeah, 1.8.
When Mae Young gave Brooks the book, hand, that's what the hand will become.
So the commentary team doesn't know a good book when they see it, because, you know, the $500 book beater is chilling right here and just, you know.
Yep. That's the key killer he's holding right there.
I don't see a Chip or a Dale or Rescue Rangers or
I
Roger
love
Rabbit
that. FF
or
one.
Like
Toothpick
Duck. I don't see anything in
the
corner.
It's over a $2,000 book all day.
Oh my God, it's a fucking 8.0. That is insane.
Yeah,
so insane that when people saw it the first time, they were like,
"Let's
I don't
get
know
the votes
that.
In."
Yeah, a lot this of people would think sense. That there's tanning on it. They don't know that the book was actually the cover wasn't actually Snow White when it came out.
Well, they don't put that on the what's it called, the little comic apps or anything like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, it's got to be in the notes, or they don't know.
The,
yeah, you're right. You're right.
Oh, it's looking like Unkind's got the lead right now.
Better not touch yourself.
Makes me sick.
You know,
who's voting for Unfinished?
I'm counting that as an Unkind vote. Let's see. Let's get some more votes in. One more vote.
Your local Bobby Ben. No more than $5 you'll probably spend on this bad boy.
I saw
I
that
like book.
Book.
Got a big old
that's
A in the corner
the
too there, Jack.
$7.50 for that book, Boston Black.
Should I say stations and see if I can get some votes?
There you go. Show your assets off, man. That usually does good.
I would, but we wouldn't be able to ever do the show again.
Okay, Unkind got it.
So I'm going to call it Unkind. You got it. So I'm going to call it.
Bring out that trivia.
So the trivia.
Uh-oh. So no one can use the thing. You can't knock them down yet?
Oh, yeah, they can use it.
No one's going to try and knock them down?
You're not going to knock them down?
Yeah, bam. If I can knock it down, let's get
them down. Knock it down.
All right, so.
Wow.
I'm the only one that got a chance. I'll knock you down, motherfucker. You're down.
No, that's
so we're down one. So you used your knockdown, so we got three knockdowns left.
Shit, I'm out of knockdowns, boys.
I thought you said originally that if they get all the way to the top and you use that knockdown, they go all the way back to the beginning.
Yeah, he's all the way to the beginning, yeah.
Oh!
So Dustin's at the bottom, so he doesn't have a chance. He's out.
Enjoy the weather down here.
So it's right now it's between these three. So it's between Biggie, Boston, and Jeffrey.
Yeah, but they can all get knocked down, right?
Yep.
Wow. Yeah. You still have a knockdown.
So if you're knocked down, you're out.
We'll figure it out as we go.
So if you're knocked down, I'm out.
No, you're. You're out right now.
But so he's out for the round.
You can knock down too. They can get.
You're out for
down
this
too.
Round. When we're doing the rounds, we're doing for okay. the rounds. When we're doing the rounds, okay. you're out. So we don't have your book. You don't show no books.
I'm just
they're
trying
showing
to see.
Books.
I got then, things to do, so I'm just trying to see if I can leave. But if I must stay,
I feel like we should be writing these walls down.
Yeah, well, we're trying to figure this out as we go.
We're figuring it out as we go, bro.
Let's see what the geriatric
has
to say.
So we're gonna give it. We're gonna go to Boston.
All right. Let's see what book do I want to show today? You know, actually, I'm gonna show you something cool just because I feel like this has to be early on in this little trend. Now, you know, one of the coolest things about going to cons is what? Cosplay, right? And so we have a cover that, you know, I think is probably one of the first. These guys were doing it before it was cool, right? And, of course, affordable. I will team up. Number, which one is this? Number 128, Captain America and Spider-Man. And look, cosplay cover. They're out in New York. They're chilling. It's a newsstand.
Nice. I actually love that cover, man.
It's awesome. It's actually a cool book.
They made another one like that with Namor on the cover as well. And Captain America and something, but yeah.
But yeah, all right, you know. Biggie. So,
I forgot to show the. When I come back, I'll show the back because, you know, I show the back. Okay.
All right, we're just going to do this.
Well, yeah.
Uh-oh.
Is he going to show the vigilante? Because we kind of saw it.
That was.
You're not hiding your cards.
Oh, damn, I want that book.
Look at him.
Damn it, that's a gorgeous book.
Well, you should have represented Johnny and that Ambo, bitch.
Yeah.
And it ain't no cosplay. Setting trends.
All right. Yeah,
the best part of the con.
Jeffrey.
The crud.
Oh, nice.
Oh, nice.
First Hulk in that title.
Yeah, it's like his ninth appearance overall.
Yes, yes.
Like I said, all he has is Hulk.
Jeffrey, you and I are the biggest Hulk fans on the show.
Yeah. You're the only Hulk fans on the show.
Hey, right. I mean, I could show Hulk books, but people don't deserve to see them.
Let's get the votes in.
I'm not taking the time to take mine off the wall.
Yo, look at the back cover of this reactor. What? Okay, who's that reactor? From Pocket Brothers Atari game. Bam.
You don't even have a board on that book. That's extra points.
Reactor, kid.
Let's get the votes in.
The bag is rippled and stuff. This came out of a discount bin.
Yeah, and you have the greatest comic book character ever on your book, and then there's Spider-Man. That tory-ass Spider-Man guy.
And I bet you won't take it out of that bag.
We already call it Biggie.
I bet you won't raw dog that book.
So Biggie's at the top of the ladder. Good. He's reaching. He's got the trivia question. Does anybody want to knock him down, or are we going to go for the trivia question?
You going to knock him down, Jeffrey?
Yeah, I'll knock him down.
Jeffrey, yeah. Are you knocked down? Jeffrey, are
you... Oh, who is me?
Who is the knockdown last?
Why not? Jeffrey, I get knocked out because fucking Dustin's out. I was the only one that had a round, so I get the trivia.
I say knocked down, so now you're out, my friend. Take a seat.
Uh-oh, you're out.
You've been knocked down.
What's gonna eventually happen?
Then
okay. Be right back.
Then whoever wins the final round, whoever wins the final round is gonna win it.
You're gonna answer that question, though, right?
Yeah, that's why. You're gonna have to have 15 books.
Boston and Jeffrey haven't won a round yet. So and we're all back to no win.
And Unkind still has the knockdown, doesn't he? Even if he's out, he can still knock somebody down.
Yeah, he still has a knockdown. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, he can still knock
somebody
down.
Him and Boston still have a knockdown.
Yeah. You know what? I'm gonna go with something that's a little Bronze Age, and it's a fun-ass book because, you know, you see Captain America in a wrestling ring, and what are we doing? We're wrestling. This is comics. I mean, if this book doesn't win, then I don't know if people are stupid.
I've got that. That's a cool comic, actually. I have that.
All
right, Jeffrey.
I'll go with this one. Ouch!
Yeah. I could show my other side of Comic Bomb, but you know what? This is better.
Ooh, you know damn.
All right, let's get the votes in.
Where's the rest of the rope?
Am I still out?
Yeah, you're still out. Yeah, it's just them two right now. Yeah.
Oh, they have to get knocked down too. Okay.
Yeah. Is this how it's going to end up going? Like, this...
we're all going to get to the top. We're all going to get knocked down.
Hey, it's a ladder match. Damn it!
Can I run into the ring and tip the ladder over?
So Biggie and I are the only two with a knockdown left.
No, you and Chris.
All right, so you guys are screwed because we don't play.
So
yeah, no. That's
so fine. This is going to be like spine ticks. We'll be up till 5 a.m. before the show's over.
No, that's all.
Yeah,
over.
But it's actually going to be interesting.
Y'all go piss my girl off.
No,
imagine
we'll
if
we be up until 3 a.m, Dan.
Oh, shit.
So you'll Jeffrey's got people. This one. Jeffrey's on the top of the ladder.
Knockdown.
Good job.
Yeah, yeah. I'm the guy that knocked your old ass down. That's right. Somebody check a tip.
Boston is the only one left. Boston can automatically answer the trivia question and go to the top of the ladder. Boston.
Anybody got knocked down? Boston, you need to knock him down.
Knock him down, Big.
Get the fuck out of here,
bro. Oh, wait. That's the fucking one with one left. Oh, so you're not going to use the knockdown? You can use the trivia?
He's right, got so his knockdown. He's
Boston's the only one with the knockdown left.
Give it to Chris.
Yes.
He deserves it.
All right, Boston. Name.
Well, he's got to answer the fucking trivia.
He's got to answer the trivia.
I got a good one.
Boston's at the top. This is crazy.
Make that shit hard.
So, trivia question is, name at least 5 world heavyweight champions.
5 heavyweight champions in the hunt?
No, it doesn't. Just 5. It can be in the hunt, WWE, Impact, anywhere you want to name.
That's a tall. All right.
John Cena, Ric Flair, Hulk Hogan, let's see, Ultimate Warrior,
Boston,
and
the Immortal BiggieShaq,
Boston,
Sting. There we go. There's 5.
2 of them aren't world heavyweight.
And we have the comic in the bank. We got our first winner. See, they go all night. See.
I would actually like to dispute that one.
Yeah, I was fine.
We need to win another hour.
We got to work the bugs out of this game.
No, hey, I want to dispute that. I have an ultimate one.
I really wanted to show this next heavyweight champion.
He only won a world champion.
Put that thrasher back up. Put that thrasher back up, buddy.
Alright, we can break kayfabe and stuff, so yeah.
Yeah.
God damn, later. I don't
participate
in that. Fucking Dustin just leave. He just said fuck it.
Yeah, he's done. Wow. He did that last time. Yeah, he's like, I'm out of here.
Didn't even say bye, son of a bitch.
So man, yeah, so We're gonna work the bugs out of it, but you kind of get the gist of it. It's kind of fun. So it's like we got to get the knockdown system worked kind of fun. That was kind of cool because it was like, all right, because it ended up being, you know, Boston Chris saved his, and then he ended up being on top of the ladder last.
Yeah, I guess we have to work on the logistics later. It's not gonna be worth it talking about it now. But congratulations, Chris.
Yeah.
What's funny about this is my sister's watching the Neverending Story. So like I have that musical when they go to the Ivory Tower in the background. So it's like it works perfect. I'm just sitting there.
Yo, Dustin legit did my favorite comic book wrestling promo. Like I'm sure he don't mean that towards Tony. But that felt like real heat, and it was just good, dude. I'm really proud of Dustin tonight. He did great.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah, I'm still challenging that win though, because Wario didn't win a world heavyweight champion. It was just a world champion. There's a difference.
Hey man, look, I named him. It's up to the judges to say who did or who didn't.
Okay.
I was just going to say, Chris, you did a great job selling those dollar bin books, man. It was entertaining just to hear you listen to promote those things.
Hey, that's what it's going to be for. Like, I mean what I said. Just when it comes down to it, to break kayfabe, to really put it out there, you know, I'm not angry per se, but, you know, I don't have a little bit of a chip on my shoulder, and I don't think I'm going to be dropping all these good books just to waste them every time I go up against somebody else, because that kind of gets on my nerves a little bit.
You won by not getting one fucking round, and then you
it's the equivalent of him sitting outside the ring while everybody beat themselves up with the ladder.
Yeah,
and fucking then, like, Dolph Ziggler move.
Yeah, and then he slides in at the end.
No, that is. That's Jerry Lawler hiding under the ring in the Royal Rumble and then expecting to win it.
But well, that's kind of cool. That's kind of fucking cool. Did anybody expect
He came in with the right attitude, though. He used just normal
shitty
books.
Yes, that's true. Go ahead, Big. I'm sorry.
They wanted to put us all over, and he put himself over. So, congratulations. That was slick. So,
well, it's like Jeffrey winning the world champion with no book. You won with no book, man.
Basically, because you showed nothing but dollar bin books.
No,
with comic in the bank.
This is different, though.
And that's the fun part.
People actually voted for Jeffrey, though.
Just to let people know, I have thousands.
That's great.
Here's the difference between when Jeffrey won with no books. Jeffrey didn't show up to that.
No, I was there.
Oh, shit. He he was there, bro. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
Okay, so that was... Okay, here's the deal with that. That was the early days of the hunt where we, like, really had rules that we followed.
Yeah, I remember that, Jeffrey.
And we literally, it was what you hunted that week
I know, but isn't there, like... I remember one time where it was just, like, your screen just...
He was blacking out on purpose. Yeah, that was during that.
He ain't
making it up. You got a good memory, Barrett, dude. That's okay.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that was fun tonight.
That is true. He was doing that a little bit.
Yeah,
because
that was one time.
It would be his turn, and then his fucking camera would go out.
Yeah,
that's
what I remember. Like when he won without the book. Like that's what I remember.
So.
It's like I
won playing a Millennium Falcon, so you know. I think all is fair in love and war when it comes to the hunt. I think something just cool.
I beat Doc with Bleak once.
So you got anything coming up, Bleak?
Anything coming up? I think I'm gonna be on Spine Ticks tomorrow night. I got a Comikhan tomorrow. That's gonna be fun.
They do things in Canada.
Yeah, Niagara Falls Comic Con's tomorrow, so I'm going to be going to that. What else
you know?
Doing?
You know who's
going
to be there?
Yeah, a bunch of assholes. Captain Kirk's going to be there. Nobody great. Ken Lashley's going to be there.
Big Daddy Cool.
Yeah, I like Ken Lashley. I've got a couple signatures from him.
Big Daddy Cool's going to be there. Evil.
I don't think he's coming, man.
I saw it on Instagram like 12 minutes. Like, if I can find my doohickey.
He's supposed to be there. There's supposed to be a couple of good wrestlers there, but in Niagara Falls, they tend to fucking back out at the last minute, so we'll see what happens.
I saw it on the Instagram.
Especially when they have to cross the border and everything. So
Spike.
I might got something coming up soon. We've been in the talks. But if there is, I'll let people know. I got some news today. Plans fell through, but it's looking like something might happen in the near future with Spike here. All
right.
Do not miss the match with the Ancient One and Spike in 2 weeks. That's going to be fun.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's almost like fall. All
right. Jeffrey, man, good to see you back, bro.
Very nice.
Thanks, man.
It's
fun. Always.
Anything going on? Man, I would be just like Jeffrey right now.
Yeah, fuck that.
So he will be though tomorrow 10-6 and then 10-3 on Sunday.
Beautiful. I might have a Kevin Nash book actually.
I'll be on my segment Comic Book Corner, Dan's Comic Book Corner with Ian Hoodrat on this coming Monday. I don't know if we're having Whodat on or not. We're bringing him back at some point. He's always fun to have on. What we're going to talk about in my segment is the bomb that was dropped on everyone last Wednesday with CGC's decision to limit what they're going to show. That's going to change the market substantially. So we'll get into the details of that and some perspective you haven't heard of. And then the upcoming She-Hulk. There's another element of segments we're going to talk about, what to expect, what not to expect. And I hope they don't screw up on this series.
I thought you were talking about a different bomb.
Yeah, so that's Monday, 8 o'clock Pacific, 11 Eastern on Monday night.
All right.
When you're talking about that CGC bomb, don't forget to say what CBCS said in their clap back to them.
Oh, yeah. Bunch of things to talk about.
Yeah, it was good.
They like big books and they cannot lie.
That's it.
I got the tag match rematch next time on the hunt. Me and my boy Comic Head did a rap video and it's on his channel. It's called Mega Powers, I believe. And then Tuesday I'll be going to Cookie Shop and I'll be starting my ginormous run for the GSX. And when I get my GSX, I expect a world championship out of that motherfucker. So whoever has the belt, Tony, is going with the GSX.
No telling on that because you got to watch out for Mr. Comic in the Bank out here. I got to watch out for this guy.
You never know what's up I'm going to show. Just because, hey,
I
I'm just kind of feeling this whole dollar book thing, so my comic in the bank is just chilling. We'll see what happens. Pick the right moment, maybe go ahead and grab a world championship. For me, I'm just kind of chilling. I do have some stuff I probably could show, or I should make a video for. You know, it's just trying to get the time to do it, but I will be doing that at some point. And then I'm also trying to get some books organized to go on some of these shows, or the selling shows. So we'll see what happens. Keep an eye out for that. If I do end up going on any of the you know, seller shows, I will go ahead and make a preview video, let everybody know, just because I do have some pretty good books that I think I'm going to go ahead and part ways with, just because I'm trying to get some bigger books. Kind of like, you know, in the same vein of BiggieShaq, not a GSX, but trying to, you know, just move some other stuff so I can get some things that I've always wanted to grab. So,
an FF1. He wants an FF1, everybody. Don't. And if he says otherwise, he's lying.
Well, this has been The Hunt, people. In 2 weeks, join us again. We'll be back. As you said, it'll be the tag team championships on the line. TM Nerdy will be back defending his cover championship. And hopefully Lady Fantastic will be healed up and ready to defend her title. So we'll see. And we got to find out what's going on with this Slapdown invasion, man. We got to find out what's going on with this, because they were in the back in the locker room, and we can't be having that here on The Hunt, man. We can't be having that. No invasion stuff, man. So we'll catch. Oh, and if you want to support the show, like and subscribe. And
we got merch. Go buy it.
Yeah, we got merch in the description. The description.
Buy that stuff.
So, it's dope ass merch.
We'll catch you guys later.